if you're at all attracted to the ocean, then you really want to see what's going on under the surface. You want to be there with the fish and the anemones and the sea stars. And what we teach, with my co-instructor Siobhan, what we teach in Subtidal Science is we teach you how to work underwater, how to collect data. So the diving becomes sort of secondary. You don't even think about the diving, and then you learn how to design survey programs. You learn all the techniques that you need to be able to collect data and do science underwater. And it's amazing. We go to lots of different sites around here. We dive in beautiful, beautiful areas. We learn to identify a whole heap of different species. And then our students do a project, their own research, underwater research project, which then they write up. And it's just awesome.
It's incredible. I love being part of the students' discovery. I see students come here already as divers, and they start off with some intimidation of the ocean, and by the end of the course, there's such confidence and taking charge. It's so wonderful to see.
For Subtidal Science, and this is my second time TAing the course, and I love TAing it at Banfield because it's a small course and you get to interact with all of these students who, some of them just learned to dive, some of them have been diving for a long time, but most of them have never done research underwater. So it's really cool seeing them start at the beginning of the course as, you know, like competent divers, but then by the end of the course they're able to like carry all this gear underwater. And they know all these different survey methods, and they're also really, really stoked on IDing fish and nudibranchs and sea stars. And that's just really cool to see them go from like recreational divers to people who are really invested in subtidal science and scientific methods.